Hello students. Previous session we had completed the subtopic that is about the chemical and physical properties of metals and non-metals through various activities. Today we shall look for one more activity, that is the reaction of metals and non-metals. That means today we shall see how do metals react with non-metal. So we will see the reaction between metal and a non-metal. And while going through this activity, we shall also see some of the important and new concept, that is about the cations and anions. Now, what are these cations? Before we go for this the reaction of metals and non-metals, first we must know about the these terms, cations and anions. Let us see what are these. So, atoms which donate electrons, they are called as cation. The atoms of the elements. You know that all the elements are made up of atoms, and the atoms of the elements, or simply you can say the elements, okay. So the elements which donate means which give, okay. Already about these things I have explained a bit in your guidance classes, right. So just recall that the elements or the atoms of the elements which donate electrons, they are called as cations, okay. The atoms which donate electrons, they are called as cations, and they will be having what kind of charge? They will be having positive charge on them. Likewise, atoms of the elements which receive electrons, okay, the atoms of the element which receive, that means which take electrons, they are called as anions, okay, anions, and the elements will be having the negative charge on them. Simply, just take it in a simple way, if the element donates electron, it will be called as cation and it will have a positive charge. But whereas if an element receives electron, it will be considered as anion and it will be having a negative charge. The best example for to understand this is we shall take sodium chloride, NaCl. Here sodium, it is a metal. We will see two things in this sub-point, that is you will see the reaction between the metal and non-metals also. In this concept you can see sodium, it is a metal, whereas chloride is a non-metal. So we will see the reaction of metal with the non-metal also. Also we shall come across this term through this reaction only. So it is a metal, sodium, it will donate one electron to the chlorine. It will donate one electron, hence it will get positive charge. Whereas chlorine, it will receive one electron from the sodium, hence it will get a negative charge. Okay, here we can get sodium for cation and chlorine for anion. Okay, now we shall see the reaction of metals with non-metals, also the exchange of electrons between them. Along with this, we shall come across one more property, that is ionic compound. So we will also know about the ionic compounds. But to discuss the properties of ionic compounds, first we must know what are ionic compounds. So ionic compounds. Ionic compound means the compounds formed by the transfer. Compounds formed by the transfer of electrons from a metal to a non-metal. Okay. If a compound, you know, sodium chloride, it is a compound, right? What is it like compound? If two or more elements combine together, then it is called as compound. What is compound? If two or more elements or solution combine together, then it is called as compound. Now here we can see two elements. They have combined together forming sodium chloride. Now sodium chloride is a compound. Now the compound formed. If the formation of the compound is happened by the transfer of electrons, by the transfer of electrons from a metal to a non-metal, or from one element to another element, that will be considered as ionic compound. So this example we can take is sodium chloride is also an example for ionic compound. Similarly, we have magnesium chloride also. So magnesium will be having positive. Magnesium, it will donate one electron to chlorine, hence chlorine will get negative charge and magnesium will get positive charge. So all these are the examples for the ionic compounds. What are ionic compounds? The compounds which are formed by the transfer of electrons from a metal to a non-metal. They are called as ionic compounds. And students, like how metals and non-metals, we have gone through that some properties of the metals and non-metals. Even this ionic compound, they pose their own certain properties. So those properties will be, they have the physical nature, they have different physical nature. So we will see the properties of ionic compounds. So they will have the different physical nature, they will have separate melting and boiling points, and solubility, and also the conduction of electricity. So we will discuss in detail about the properties of these ionic compounds. There is we have divided the four properties of the ionic compounds as physical nature. We will see the melting and boiling point of ionic compounds, and also the solubility of ionic compounds with conduction of electricity. Okay, so we will go through these properties of ionic compounds, and also the reaction of metals and non-metals along with the cations and the anion terms. Okay, all these things we will discuss in detail through this video.
How do metals and non-metals react? Metal atoms have 1, 2, 3 electrons in the outermost shell, whereas non-metals atoms have 4, 2, 8 electrons in the outermost shell. But there are some exceptions, two exceptions to this rule, hydrogen and helium. Metals that donate electrons gain positive charge equal to the number of electrons donated, and non-metals gain electrons and negative charge equal to the number of electrons accepted. When a metal atom donates electron, 1, 2, or 3 electrons from its valence shell to another non-metal atom that has the ability to accept these electrons, it is known as electrovalency. As a result of this, both these atoms form the structure of an inert gas. The transfer of electrons from the atom of an element to the atom of another is called an ionic compound. Properties of ionic compounds. Let us look at some ionic compound properties. First is physical nature. Ionic compounds are hot solids, as the force of attraction between the positive and negative ions is very strong. These compounds are brittle and break when pressure is applied. Second is melting and boiling points. Ionic compounds have high melting point and boiling points because of a considerable amount of energy that is required to break the strong inter-ionic attraction. Third is solubility. Ionic compounds are soluble in water and insoluble in solvents such as kerosene, petrol, and so on. Fourth, conduction of electricity. Ionic compounds, when in solid state, do not conduct electricity because of the rigid structure. But when ionic compounds are in a molten state, it is possible to conduct electricity, as the electrostatic force of attraction between the oppositively charged ions are overcome due to the heat. This leads to ions to move freely and conduct electricity.
Copy down and note down all the important points on the blackboard along with the points which will be highlighting in the animated video also. Okay, and submit your homework and the explanation notes and the classwork notes on prescribed timetable. Thank you.